Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to design and create this high-energy DJ dance club poster. I provided this image of a DJ controller for the background so you can follow along. Its link is located in the video description or project files. Feel free to use a different photo, however, the finished poster will look best if the photo you're using is taken from above. I provided the links to all the fonts I'll be using in this video. First, make your foreground and background colors white and black respectively. To do this, press D on your keyboard and then either press X or click this icon. Let's make the background into a smart object so we can modify the image non-destructively. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. You know it's a smart object when you see this icon. Create a new layer below it by Control-clicking or Command-clicking on the new layer icon. We'll fill it with black. And since black is our background color, press Control or Command plus Delete. Click the thumbnail of the DJ controller to make it active, and go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Sketch folder and click Photocopy. Make the detail 24 and the darkness 5, then click OK. Click the FX icon and choose Color Overlay. Click the color box and pick a dark, rich color. You can always change it later if you want. I already picked my color, so I'll type it in. 1A00FF. Once you pick your color, click OK or press Enter or Return. Change the blend mode to darker color and click OK. If you want to increase the contrast a bit more, click the adjustment layer icon and click Brightness Contrast. Increase the contrast to 100. As I toggle back and forth, you can see the subtle difference. Let's group all the layers that comprise our background into a folder. Shift-click on the bottom layer to highlight all the layers and press Ctrl or Command G. Let's name it Base. Open your horizontal type tool and pick a font for your main words. I'm using Aldo the Apache Regular. For this font, I'll use a size of 314 points. However, you may want to temporarily use a smaller size to make sure your text fits your document. Choose Sharp and Center Alignment. Click on the center of your document and type out your text. Open your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool. To see the Transform's entire bounding box, press Ctrl or Command 0. Drag it to the center and move your cursor just outside a corner. When you see a curved double arrow, rotate it counterclockwise to an angle you like. Then press Enter or Return. Convert your text into a smart object. Click the FX icon and choose Color Overlay. Click the color box and pick a bright color. For mine, I'll type in EA00FF. Go to Filter, Blur, and Motion Blur. Make the angle between minus 50 to minus 80 and the distance between 45 to 50 pixels. Go to Filter, Distort, and Wave. Slide the number of generators all the way to the right and make the wavelength and amplitude 1 and 3 each. The type is sine and tick Repeat Edge Pixels. Then click OK. To save space, click the arrow next to the FX icon to collapse the effects. Press T to open your type tool and click on your document. For my secondary text, I'll choose Barcode Font Regular. Go to Window and Character. The character panel will open. I'll make the size 304 points and the tracking 200. Tracking is the amount of space between your characters. Type out your text. Highlight it. Click the color box and pick a color. I'll pick Coral 01FFD8. Then click OK. Reduce its opacity to 30%. To reposition it, click your Move tool and drag it below your main text. We want to place it behind the main text, so simply drag it under the main text in the Layers panel. Press T to open your type tool and click on the upper left of your document. Choose a font for the venue, date, and time. I'm using Dense Regular. I'll make its size 90 points and click Left Alignment. Click the color box and pick White. Type out the name of the venue. Open your Move tool and reposition it comfortably on the upper left. Open your Type tool again, click on your document, reduce the point size, and type out the address of the venue. Open your Move tool to reposition it. Continue until you have all of your text. Let's group the venue, address, date, and time into a folder. Shift-click on the bottom text to highlight all the layers between it and the active layer, and then press Ctrl or Command G. Name the folder whatever you'd like. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Make the original text folder active and convert it into a smart object so we can distort and blur all the text layers inside this folder. We can close the character panel now. Go to Filter, Blur, and Motion Blur. Make the angle 90 degrees and the distance 500 pixels. Go back to Filter, Distort, and Zigzag. Make the amount 10, the ridges 5, and the style around center. Click the FX icon and choose Color Overlay. Click the color box and pick a color for the wavy lines that are behind your white text. I'll pick a similar coral color that I picked earlier. Once you pick your color, click OK on both windows. If you'd like to modify any of the elements of your poster, you can quickly and easily do it because we saved most of them as smart objects. For example, I think I'd like the DJ controller background have a bit less detail in the medium tones, so I'll scroll down to my base folder, which is where my background is, and click the arrow next to the folder to open it. I'll double-click the Filter Gallery effect, which will open the photocopy filter. I'll reduce the darkness to 3, which darkens the grays. Then I'll click OK. As I toggle back and forth, you can see the difference. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.